You will learn so many things in this video, from making highlights to adding this cold snowy effect on face. So make sure to stick to the end. First, we'll take a document of 1920 by 1080. Then click on Create. Now import the background, scale it to fit the canvas, right-click on it and then flip horizontally. Then go to Filter and then Camera Raw Filter. Then in the Light section, increase the exposure a little and lighten the blacks and shadows, experiment with sliders and see what looks best, then click on OK. Then we'll import our subject layer. Right-click on the layer and convert to Smart Object. Then simply drag it to our main document. Scale it down and position where you want it. I've generated this location pin icon with this prompt in Bing AI. We'll use this in the design. If you want to know more about Bing AI, I'll link the video in description. Now click on this image and right-click on it and copy image. Then in Photoshop, press Ctrl V to paste it. Take any selection tool from here and then select subject. Now with selection active, click on this button to create a mask. To fix this selection, double-click on the mask. Then take the shift edge slider to left. Increase feather a little, and then increase the contrast to make the edges sharper. Then click OK. Right-click and flip horizontally, then adjust the size and position. Now I did something here which later I changed it, so I'm skipping that part. Just ignore it for now. Now make a solid color layer above the location icon layer. Choose red color and click on OK. Change its blending mode to color. Now I'll take this watercolor brush which I downloaded from brusheasy.com. Then select the mask and paint with black color. Paint like this on some areas. It will give the feeling like it's getting frozen. Now we'll make some highlights on the face. For it, click on this icon and then click on hue and saturation. Now hold Alt key and click between these two layers to make a clipping mask. Now drag the lightness slider to right. Left click on the mask and then press Ctrl I to invert the mask. Take the brush tool from here and right click on canvas to choose a soft round brush. Decrease the flow to 14%. And make the brush smaller and increase the hardness a little. Then start painting like this. Paint slowly, and don't go over the beard. We will make a separate layer for the beard and head. This side already has some highlights. We only have to paint over it to make it more visible. Once done painting, make the brush bigger and softer. Press X to switch between these colors, with black color in foreground. Paint like this to erase. We just have to make some edges softer. See before and after. Then paint some highlights on the ear like this. Then create a new hue saturation layer with same settings, but this time we'll paint on the beard. Again do the same thing as before. First paint on the areas you want, and then erase the excessive. When it's done, double-click on the right side of this layer. Slowly start dragging this black slider in the underlying layer from left to right. Click on it while holding Alt key to break it. Drag the part away to make the transition smoother. See, it made the highlights natural. Click OK and then remove the extras. Now similarly paint some highlights on the head. See before and after, it makes a huge difference. Using the same method, I painted some more highlights on the bag straps and the body. Now for the snow effect, we'll use this image which I found from Google as a reference. First we had to make some areas of the skin red like the reference image, and for that, create a hue saturation layer. Clip it to the subject layer, increase the saturation, decrease lightness, and then use the hue slider to create a red tone on the face. Try to match as much as possible. Then select the mask and press Ctrl I to invert it. Take brush tool and decrease the flow. With white as foreground color, paint according to the reference image. Decrease the opacity if it's too much. Then create a new white solid color for the snow effect, and no need to make a clipping mask of it. Just invert the mask. Take brush tool and right-click on the canvas. Go to this folder of dry media brushes. These are default Photoshop brushes. You don't need to download them. Select this Kyle Ultimate Charcoal brush. Set the flow to 11%. And then paint gradually on the areas as the reference image. Try to match as much as possible. Don't overdo it. Just see the reference image and paint on those areas. Mostly it's on the hair, like the beard, eyelashes, eyebrows. Just paint and then erase extras, this is the method. The process will exactly be the same, so I am speeding up some parts. See before and after. Now click on this icon and then drop shadow. Add just a little amount of shadow to add some depth. Select the background layer and press Ctrl M for Curves Adjustment Layer. Create a point here and drag it up to lighten up the shadows a little more. Then hit OK. Then I selected a part of the lake with lasso tool and placed it on the rocks and faded out the edges with simple masking. Made a hue saturation layer below subject layer and decreased lightness and painted some shadows behind for a better contrast. Now make a black solid color below location pin layer for its shadow. Right click on canvas with brush tool. From here, squeeze or compress the brush tip like this. Make the brush softer and then just dab once to make the shadow. Then you can scale it to match the angle and also change the color. And lower the opacity. Now take type tool and we'll write the temperature, and then we'll place it here. To adjust the spacing between letters, double click on the text and then click between two letters. While holding Alt key, press arrow keys to adjust the spacing. Then add shadows to it with same method. Add slight drop shadow to it. And then add some shadow in the background with hue saturation layer. Now add the location name, make it bigger, right click on the text layer and convert to smart object, and then right click on it, then perspective, drag this bottom point like this, right click and go back to scale and make it smaller. Add some shadow to it also. Now we'll import this in our design, click on the layer and press Ctrl C, now here, press Ctrl V to paste. Scale it down and position it somewhere around here like this. Then we'll add some snow to the hand as well, with the same method as before. Now instead of just one line, I changed the text to be in top and bottom, for better visibility. Lastly, added the country flags around the design with slight motion blur. Finally, added the camera raw filter with these settings. In the light section, increased the blacks and shadows. Increased some vibrance in the color section. Increased the clarity and texture in the effects section. Here in color mixer section, decreased the saturation of aquas and blues. And lastly added some sharpness in detail section. Then just hit OK. Lowered its the opacity to 55%. I know, the text in the background can be a lot better. I just wanted to share the techniques and hope these will help you in your designs. Anyways, here's the final result. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you found this video helpful.